Hello everyone, welcome to my channel TechnoEd Learning. Today in this video I will be demonstrating on how to generate an e-certificate based on the Google form. Now if I am generating an online quiz, I want that after successful completion of the quiz, the participants should get an e-certificate on their email ID. So for this, first I will make an online quiz in the Google form. The procedure for it is already discussed in my previous video, so you can check that as well. Now this is my quiz based on the fluid mechanics subject, and I want the participants to attempt this quiz, and on successful completion they should get an e-certificate on their email ID. Now to generate the e-certificate, you are supposed to install an add-on called CertifyM on your Google form. You can see here the icon of add-on. If I click here, I can see the CertifyM. Okay, this is because I have already installed it. If you haven't installed it on your Google form, you won't see this add-on. So what you are supposed to do is go to this three dots saying more, then click on add-on. Okay, so once you click on this add-on, you will get this G Suite marketplace. Click here and type CertifyM. Okay, so you can see it is already installed on my Google form. Click here. Now if it is not installed on your Google form, you will get an option of install here. Since I have already installed it, I have got an option of uninstall. Okay, after you have installed it, close it, refresh your Google form. Okay, then you will get the add-on icon here like this. Click on this and you will get this CertifyM option also. Click on this. Okay, then go to show CertifyM controls. Okay, so this pop-up window appears. So I have kept the certification on, that is after successful completion of this quiz and passing it, the participants will automatically get the e-certificate on their email ID. Okay, this is the certificate records. Whoever attempts the quiz and get the certificates, okay, everything will be recorded in this CertifyM record. See, this way. Okay, then I'll show you the more options here. Here you can see the passing percentage. You can keep the passing percentage from 0 to 100%. For example, if this is a feedback form and I want to give certificate to all the participants who fills the feedback form, so I can keep the passing percentage at 0%. Okay, now this is a quiz and I want the participants to get the certificate if they get marks of 50% or more than that, so I'll keep it as 50%. Then you have the template. Now there are various templates available, already predefined template. You can preview them. See, these are the various templates that are already available. Okay, so say if I have liked this teal banner, okay, I'll close it. For template, I'll search for teal banner. See, here it is. Okay, and then I'll go to this advanced option. So in this advanced option, see, what do you want to show the message after submission of this quiz? See, this is already the predefined message. You can change it as well. Okay, then name of the sender, email options these are. So I'll say the name of the sender. Okay, subject of the email, congratulations, I'll say, for passing FM quiz. You can give any subject for the mail that you want. Then content of the body, congratulations, here is your certificate. Okay, so you can enter whatever content you want and click on save changes. So this is how you have added the add-on CertifyM, and also the certificate is being added, which is the steel banner, which was already predefined template of CertifyM. Now I will show you how you can get the certificate in that particular format. So now I'll attempt this quiz. Make sure that email address should be there in your quiz so that the certificate can be received on that particular email address. Okay, so I'll attempt the quiz. So if I get more than 50% of marks, then and only then I'll get an A certificate. So I'll attempt the quiz. Okay, and submit it. So this is a message that I have already shown you. Thank you for your submission. If you pass, you will receive a printable certificate shortly. This was the already predefined message. You can change it also from the advanced settings. Now I will see whether I have got the certificate or not. I'll refresh. Still not. Maybe because of the poor internet connection. Let's check again. See here. I have got my certificate. Congratulations for passing FM quiz. Click here. So this is my certificate. I have got 80%. My name, my college name, the quiz name. Okay. So this was the already predefined template which was present in CertifyM. You can use them as well. Okay. So this is how you can pass the certificate to the registered email ID. Whoever passes the quiz, automatically the certificate will be sent to them. Okay, now if I want to customize the template, I don't want this predefined ones, so I'll go to again this quiz. Okay, now I have already selected. See, I'll go to preview all and I will show you again. All these were the predefined templates. Now I don't want the predefined templates, I want my own customized template. So what I can do is click here again and click on use a custom template. Okay, click here. So it is showing me the current template is the teal banner. I can select a new template from my drive. Okay, so I'll click on this, select a new template. So whatever presentations and Google Slides are there on my drive, it will be shown. So this is one of the template that I have already made. So I'll click here and select and say the template name is Certificate for FM1 Quiz, and then I will click on Save Changes. I will also show you how you can make the template of it. So you can see the template is being changed now. Okay. Again, I can go to this advanced setting and change whatever I want to change here. Say I will, this predefined message, I will change it. If you pass with 50% and more marks, you will receive a printable certificate. Okay, everything I will keep it as same now and click on Save Changes. Okay, now I will attempt the quiz once again. Then college name, next I'll attempt the quiz now. Okay, so I'll submit it now. You can see the message is changed now. Okay, there was an error with the spelling mistake. Okay. So if you have passed with 50% and more marks, you will receive a printable certificate shortly. So this was the message that I have entered in the advanced settings. So it is shown here. Now I will again go to my inbox and check if I have got the certificate, if I have passed the quiz. See here, I have got the certificate now. Congratulations for passing FM quiz. Click here, see the content and my certificate. So now this certificate is in the new format, the customized template which I have already made in the Google slide. You can see the percentage is also there, the quiz name, college name, the participant name. Okay, so this is how you can use the customized template also. Now to use the customized template, there are some precautions, like I'll show you. So this is my customized template. What you can do is, you can create a customized template with the blank for name, for college name, and whatever content you want from the participants, you can keep those things blank. And you can make a template of it in, say, Photoshop or PPT or Word, and save it as a JPG file as a photo. So you can use this Google slide. Now Google slide is same as the Google form, Google sheet, that is the app of Gmail. So Google slide is also the app of Gmail. So go to the Google slide and paste your photo of that particular template. Okay, or you can make your own template in this Google slide. Google slide is same like the presentation PPT, PowerPoint presentation. It's same like the PowerPoint presentation. Okay, so now here is what I have created, a template in the Google slide. I have given you one option, that what you can do is, you can create a template, save it as the photo, that is JPG file, as a photo format, and then you can paste it here. But here you have to see this identifiers. You can see here the full name written in the curve brackets, other identifier written in the curve brackets. Okay, what else? The person, date, title. What I want is, whatever the participants enters into this quiz, okay, so all those things should come by default automatically on my certificate when it goes to their email ID. That is, the full name, whatever he enters on the Google form, that is on the quiz, that should come automatically on my certificate. Other identifier is nothing but the college name. Then percentage, how much he gets from the quiz, that should automatically get entered in this certificate. And date on which he attempted the quiz. So these are called the merge tags or merge fields, and this is how you should enter it. Now how do you get this? Go to this Google form again. Okay, now go to this preview all again. Okay, you can see here for instructions, click here. Okay, go down, see merge tag and description. When you want the name of the participant, you are supposed to use this merge tag, full name of the exam taker, and it should be the first question in the exam after your email collection, correct? Then next is the title of the Google quiz. So you can, I'll show you my certificate. You can see here title written in the curve brackets. This all you are supposed to enter. Okay, the format is supposed to be like this. Okay, then other identifier, the first optional, the other identifier which follows the full name. So in my Google form, after full name is the college name. So I have used this other identifier merge tag for that. See here, other identifier. Okay, now similarly, what else? Date in the format, which format you want. Again, date 2 in which format, DDMM, YYYY. I wanted it in this format, so I have kept this merge tag. Percent, that is exam taker score, okay, and certificate ID, that is the unique identification number. So all this I have entered here. You can see certificate ID, percent, date, title, other identifier, full name. So all this should come on your certificate. The template will be same, but this everything should be written on the Google slide on your customized template of the certificate, so that automatically all the content of the quiz, whoever attempts it, gets printed here and he gets it on his email ID automatically. Okay, so this is how you can create a customize your own certificate format, and this is how you can send the certificate automatically to the participants who attends the quiz. Make sure you are collecting the email address at first. Okay, thank you so much. If you have liked this video, do share, like, and subscribe to my channel. Thank you so much.